Hi everyone and welcome back to my channel. In this video I'll show you how to polar align with the Skywatcher EQM-35-Pro. I managed to do polar alignment with the telescope on and the weight, but I do not recommend you this because it will be harder to work with the azimuth knobs and altitude knobs having all this weight on your mount. So my recommendation is to start without the telescope, without the camera and without the counterweight. So for this I will take the camera off and the telescope, and I'll show you exactly how to polar align using the EQM-35-Pro. Okay, so we are ready to start. I removed all the weight from the mount, so it will be very easy to use the azimuth knobs and the altitude knobs to place Polaris in the polar finder reticle like you have here on your phone application. You need to know where Polaris is in the sky. So if you do not know where is Polaris, there are some applications that can help you. I use Sky Safari on my phone. If you know where is the Big Dipper, you can actually use the Big Dipper to find Polaris. So there are two stars, Merak and Dube. And if you draw an imaginary line from Merak, almost passing through Dube, about five times the distance from Merak to Dube, you will hit Polaris with this imaginary line. So this is another useful way to find Polaris, and also it will help you if you do the alignment when it's not yet dark, when it's twilight, because this will help you. You'll not see a lot of stars in the sky, but you'll be able to spot Polaris very easy. Okay, so the first step is to find Polaris and then to place the mount in that direction. After you place the mount in the direction, you should set your correct latitude for the location you are at. And you can also find this with Polar Finder or Polar Align Pro or other applications. I also use an altimeter application for the altitude. It show me the altitude and it will show you also the coordinates. So here I have around 47 latitude and it is set it here. You set your latitude using here your altitude knobs. And after you made this step and you have set it the latitude, you have to move the mount in the position where is Polaris. Try to look above the mount in this position and see if it is approximately in the middle. Then try and see it here with the polar finder scope. If you cannot see it, try to focus here with this small focuser. Try to focus and then you should be able to see it. If it is dark, you need also this polar illuminator. So with this polar illuminator, it is not expensive, but with the EQM-35-Pro you'll need this. And the third step after you found Polaris and you see it here on your finder scope is to level your mount. For this you'll have to work here with the tripod legs and try here to adjust the legs until you will be level, and you have here a bubble level that will help you achieve this. So it will be a trial and error. It is a little bit harder to do it alone with this big tripod, but it is not impossible. It is easier if you have a flat ground. So another useful information, try to do this on a flat ground and then it will be easier to work with the tripod legs. Okay. Hello, I'm back with my EQM-35-Pro go-to mount from Skywatcher, and now I'm in the field and I'm going to show you how to set up the mount properly. First I did mounted back the counterweight bar and the accessories tray here and tighten this very good. You need to do this, and after you mounted the accessories tray, what is now very important is the leveling. It has a leveling bubble here that will help you level the mount. So first you need to make it easier for you to see the bubble, and watch here, So as I said before, when you find a place like this, extend the legs at maximum height and you'll be close to the leveling point. Then usually drop these two legs a little bit lower, so like this. And I will, so too low. It's a little bit hard to level this alone, but it's doable. So now I will lower this leg. So this is about trial and error if you are doing this alone. Now I will rest the mount to be more fixed into the ground. And yes, it is leveled. So you can see now the mount is leveled. You can see the bubble in the center. If you go in other places you travel, then using your phone with different application you can find the right latitude for that place. After you have the tripod leveled and you check the bubble level, you should watch from here. So from here it should be in the center. Polaris already should be close, should be placed very close to the circle. After you leveled, you need to work here with the azimuth knobs and altitude knobs to place Polaris like in the image on your phone application. So you should place Polaris like in the image, not in the center of the circle, but on the exterior lines, and there you'll see some numbers here. So the key is with the EQM-35-Pro, not to get confused. In my previous video, I turned 90 degrees the area axis because I did the polar align before with other mount, and I did have to turn the area axis to be able to see Polaris here in the final scope. But with the EQM-35-Pro, you can see Polaris having the mount in home position. You do not need to make any changes. It is hard to film right now inside the polar finder, but you will find a circle like this with crosshairs, and in this reticle you also find numbers that you can use to orientate. But with the EQM-35-Pro you can leave this in the home position and do not stress yourself about the numbers, because they don't really count in this situation with the EQM-35-Pro. Using the phone app, even some application will have 0 on top or 12. You can use from home position with 9 on top. Just be sure Polaris is in the reticle like in the image, and do not worry about the numbers. You can still turn the area axis, but I've noticed it saves time to just leave it here in home position. You go a little lower to be able to see it. I'm using this. Very good for your knees. So I stay down. I watch here in the polar finder scope. And then I will use the azimuth knobs to move it left and right. And here the altitude knobs to move it up and down. So this is about it. After you place Polaris like in the image on your application, I'm using Polar Finder. It is a free application. It works with Android. It is good to use more applications and to check both of them, so you are sure you'll be able to make a good alignment. So these are the steps. So you have to have the mount aligned to Polaris and to be aligned with the North Pole, so your mount will be able to follow the movement of the stars in the night sky. Actually, the Earth is rotating, but the stars appear to move. The stars look like they are moving on the sky. So now the mount will follow the stars and you'll be able to take long exposures and get very good quality images. You can do a better polar alignment if you use a pole master. I did not use one at the moment of this tutorial. If I will use in the future also pole master, I will make also a video about that. So a few simple steps: find Polaris, place your mount in that direction, then try to see Polaris here in the polar finder, then work with your, if it is the first time you do this, work with your tripod legs until you'll be able to level it correctly. This is very important, to be leveled. And then here in the polar finder you'll see some, you see two lines, one that is vertical and one horizontal. You notice if you also balance, if you change the position of your area axis, check to see if the vertical line is perpendicular with that. Try to do that. With the EQM-35-Pro you can see the North Star without having to change the position of the array axis. So you can leave it in the in home position, and from there, if you already have done these steps before, what I do to save time. In this situation I'm using the same position for my mount. I just went inside, I took the mount here, I placed it in the same position. It helps to make some marks on the ground. It is already leveled and I did not make any changes. It takes me 1 or 2 minutes to polar align. After this you place your weight, the cables, the scene scan controller, and you mount your telescope. So this will help me also speed up the imaging plan. I'm using for a while in home position because I don't want to skip star alignment. So I'm not balancing anymore because I know exactly where to put the weight now. And then I'm mounting the telescope and taking the rest of the equipment, and I'm ready to start an astrophotography plan. So I do hope this video was useful and it did help you. Do not forget to subscribe if you have not done this already. This was my tutorial on polar alignment with the EQM35-Pro from Skywatcher. I hope you liked this video and it was helpful. And I'll get back to you soon with more reviews, tutorials and astrophotography vlogs. Until then, clear sky.